Welcome to episode 1 of our Seabourn Cruises Greek Island vlog. Please subscribe to our channel and select the bell to receive notifications of our new content. Thank you. After a rapid PCR test at this layover airport, we were off to Athens. Following back-to-back red-eye flights from California, we were glad to finally be in Athens to begin our holiday. We were also just as happy to check straight into our hotel, Hotel Grand Britannia, a pre-cruise hotel for the next 2 nights. Our full 8-minute tour of this hotel can be found on our channel. Here's a minute and a half sample. Opened as a hotel in 1874, Grand Britannia was one of the first hotels in Europe to be outfitted with electricity. Grand Britannia serves as the pre-cruise hotel for Seabourn. After a bit of a cleanup, we met Seabourn representative Anna, who gave us a map with recommendations for lunch. Despite being rather hot outside, we enjoyed the walk to the Panathenaic Stadium. shortly after an 1836 archaeological excavation uncovered the ancient stadium of Herodias Atticus here, plans for reconstruction began. This site dates to 330 BC, when it was a simple race course primarily for the Panathenaic Games, a tournament held every 4 years dedicated to Athena. 500 years later, in 150 AD, Senator Herodes Atticus rebuilt the stadium in marble. Prior to 10 a.m., anyone may run for free on this track. I was asked by five very eager Aussies to watch their belongings while they ran their own impromptu Olympic trials. The first modern Olympic Games were held here in 1896. This stadium is also the site from which the Olympic flame starts its journey to current host cities of the Olympic Games. Through the entrance at lower right, there is a small museum that you can also tour. Later that night, we walked to the Parliament building across the street from our hotel. There, we were able to watch the changing of the guard for the tomb of the unknown soldier. Every soldier guards for about an hour, during which they have to stand perfectly still until it is time to switch with another guard. The ceremony is conducted in slow motion to protect their blood circulation after what has been 60 minutes of immobility. The guard's shoes weigh about 3 kilos each and have 60 nails apiece. According to folklore, the sound the shoe makes is a signal to their Greek ancestors, so they know their descendants are still around. The next day, we took the metro to the south slope of the Acropolis. The Acropolis dates from the 5th century BC and contains many sites to explore, including the famous Parthenon, as well as the Erechtheion, a temple dedicated to Athena and Poseidon, with a porch of 6 female figures. Later, while on a walk through the Plaka district, we stopped at a cafe for breakfast with really good pancakes and fresh yogurt with honey, bananas, and peaches. After a bit of a rest at our hotel, we just relaxed until a lovely dinner in the hotel's rooftop garden overlooking the Acropolis. This was a perfect end to our pre-cruise stay. We hope you've enjoyed this episode. Please consider subscribing to our channel and giving this video a thumbs up. In our next episode, we board the lovely Seabourn Ovation and begin our 14-night cruise. Thanks for watching.